If you want to collect visual expertise, being able to recognize animals, plants, motorcycles, skin cancers, anything that comes to mind, it's not as easy because computers don't handle images well.
In 2010, computer vision was actually getting pretty good for basic level categories, but it was struggling to classify things that look very similar. Birds are a great example. So all birds have the same basic layout, wings, bill, tail, belly, but the pieces that sort of differentiate them are the attributes on those parts.
It's very difficult to ask the computer, what is this, and just show it a picture. And that's what we set off to build.
In 2011, Cornell Lab of Ornithology reached out to us. They were really excited about the possibility of being able to use computer vision to recognize birds and photographs.
Luckily, we knew people at Google, and they were very enthusiastic about what we were doing. So during the past 6 years, they've given us a lot of support. Right now, the benefit for the general public is if you see a plant or an animal, you're very likely to be able to recognize it thanks to an app that we have built for you.
Anyone, anywhere in the world, can upload a photo of an animal, and they can ask, what do you think this is, to an artificial intelligence algorithm, which was developed at Caltech.
Now we can instantly give a user feedback on what they're looking at.
For the first time, you're able to leverage people's passions, their interests, their hobbies, to directly provide research data for scientists.
In the future, we are planning to make our tools available to new communities, for example, the medical community.
Currently, I am working on algorithms that utilize artificial intelligence to extract important information from cameras that biologists put out into the wild. The big question that I'm trying to answer with my research here at Caltech is, how can we create a global model of biodiversity and how it's changing over time? I would like to create a real-time model of where you can actually find species and where they're being wiped out. And if we actually have that information, we can start making important decisions about how to save those species.
At the beginning of the project, it was solely focused on getting humans to teach machines. And now the machine's actually pretty good. And so now can we flip the problem around and can we use this machine to help teach humans? That's the next step.